Today, we are inviting Professor Johan Rockström, Executive Director of the Stockholm Resilience Centre. He proposed the concept of planetary boundaries with his colleagues in 2009, and also he insisted the importance of living within the safe operating space. We are very fortunate that we could have a chance to discuss with him on these issues. Johan, could you explain about the key message from the concept of the planetary boundaries you and your colleagues proposed?
The planetary boundary framework defines scientifically the biophysical ceiling within which humanity has a safe operating space for world development on a stable and resilient planet.
As you know, the Paris Agreement is a very important milestone for the humanity. So how do you expect the individual countries and the global communities' role in achieving the agreement?
To begin with, exactly as you say, the legally binding global climate agreement in Paris is aligned with science, aiming to keep global warming down to 1.5 degrees Celsius is actually in line with the planetary boundary on climate. It is a challenging agreement because even though it's legally binding on the target, all nations have their voluntary national pathways to reduce emissions and manage ecosystems in a way that does not increase climate forcing. So the big challenge now is to have all the countries in the world really implement what they have promised and to have enforcement systems for reporting and verification that every country not only raises their ambitions so they stay within the planetary boundary on climate, but also that they really implement them. And that is what has to happen over the coming decades.
For achieving of the goals and targets of the Sustainable Development Goals, it is also important to give the scientific evidence in the political discussions. How do you think about the role of science in achieving of sustainable development goals?
The Sustainable Development Goals is the first time ever that humanity has a full people planet roadmap of desirable outcomes for social and economic development within planetary boundaries. So this is extraordinary. It is first time we have a world development that really is based on sustainable development. And I think we as a scientific community have the responsibility to define scientifically the quantitative boundaries to guide the implementation of the SDGs.
There are many discussions about the SDGs, the goals and targets. They are to some extent a little bit difficult to understand and sometimes contradictory trade-offs. So how we could minimize the trade-offs and maximize the synergy among different sustainable development goals and targets?
I agree with you. In the current development paradigm in the world, you find trade-offs between SDGs. There's clearly a trade-off, for example, between eradicating hunger and eradicating poverty and achieving the climate goal or the biodiversity goal. But I would strongly argue that if we think in terms of global sustainability, in terms of the future that we're aiming for, that we go 100% sustainable within a safe operating space and succeed in delivering all these aspirational social and economic goals, then I would say there are no trade-offs. In fact, our big challenge, the big quest we're in for, is to find the synergies. We want to decarbonize the world economy while eradicating hunger. We want to maintain and safeguard the resilience in the biosphere, meaning keeping all biodiversity that remains on Earth intact while feeding humanity. We need an economic paradigm where we can deliver economics for good human well-being that delivers on the education goal, the health goal, the equity goal, the sustainable consumption and production goals, while securing welfare and a sustainable, stable planet. So I would like to change that debate and see that every time we collide in a trade-off, which we do, it means that there's a transformation we need to accomplish in terms of the economy or the way we measure success. Should it be GDP alone, or should we start thinking about other indicators for desirable human well-being? So I think that there's a lot that can be accomplished by transitioning to a wider sustainable development paradigm.
How do you think about the role of research institutes such as IGES?
I think the role of research institutes like IGES or the Resilience Centre or the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research or the World Resource Institute or the Stockholm Environment Institute and others, they are kind of knights at the frontier of advancing interdisciplinary research for sustainable development, which can, I think, pull the classic, often quite vertical, faculty structures and universities along with them. So being at the cutting edge of advancing sustainability science, but also the ability to be very deeply engaged in co-design and co-development of knowledge, because institutes are often more closely connected to policy, more closely connected to business, more closely connected to civil society, which means that you could say that institutes like IGES has their ears on the ground and more closely connected to the real world.
IGES has just recently published a report on SDGs and business in practices. Mm. So achievement of SDGs, of course, individual countries are important, but also the private sectors, NGOs, and civil society involvement is also important. How do you think about this type of the activities?
Yeah, I would say that my experience is that over the past 10 years, the most exciting advancements in terms of transitions towards sustainable development is the interface between science and business. We spent so many decades on the science policy interface. It's still very important, but science business is so relevant also because business today is often globalized and so multinational and holds so much of the pace and scale of innovation. So I think that is really important. It's also challenging. It requires from us in the scientific community to engage with business while having, this kind of intellectual integrity intact. We find a tremendous move and demands from business to have science-based targets for their businesses in different sectors, in different regions, and that we as scientists can and should engage with business and also deliver those science targets, but that these science targets, of course, are independently advanced in peer-reviewed academic fashion.
Johan, I have a very good news that we decided to publish your book in Japanese. How you want to send a message to the Japanese political people as well as the general public?
No, it makes me very proud. And the book Big World, Small Planet summarizes all the science that takes us to planetary boundary thinking, and that we today are a big world on a small planet, and that sustainable development is the pathway to prosperity in the future. And I'm particularly proud that the book comes out in Japanese in Japan, because Japan is such a strong nation in the academic world, in the economic world, and plays such an important role to show, to be a good example of how you can combine well-being with sustainable development. So I think it's a grand opportunity to share this science with the Japanese community.
Lastly, I would like to ask you about your ideas, how we could collaborate between the IGES and the Stockholm Resilience Centre for tackling of our global challenges that we are facing.
Now, I think we have great opportunities to collaborate much closer between IGES and the Stockholm Resilience Centre. And together with IGES, we could have resilience thinking applied much more widely in policy and development and business. We can have a lot of opportunities of finding strong synergies, not least given that IGES is such a prestigious institute and has also a global perspective, where we have many times more of a local application of resilience thinking. So I think there are many interesting complementarities and synergies?
We could have a very good discussion on the role of the science in decision-making processes, and also the role of the research institutes like IGES. We are really hoping that we could further collaborate with him and his colleagues for achieving of the global sustainability.